In this video, we present neural spline fields for burst image fusion and layer separation. The world is filled with scenes that we do want to photograph, hidden behind unavoidable obstructions that we don't want to photograph. Yet with off-the-shelf methods, it proves extremely challenging to even identify, let alone segment, these arbitrary and often out-of-focus obstructions. In this work, we leverage small motion cues naturally generated by unstabilized handheld photography, to, directly from a small video clip, estimate a high-quality alpha mat of the obstruction and recover the hidden scene behind it. In the following sections, we describe our test time optimization approach for image fusion and layer separation, fit to a single input video with no pre-training or paired ground truth data. Starting with a stack of slightly misaligned images, we model camera translations and rotations for these frames as two smooth cubic splines in 3D space. Applying this camera pose to our frame from time t, we sample a point in the image and randomly generate a 3D ray, calculating its intersection with two depth planes, one representing the obstruction and one representing transmitted content hidden behind the obstruction. However, while this two-plane model can compensate for some parallax effects, we're missing a granular representation of depth and motion in the scene. This is where we introduce neural spline fields, compact and versatile optical flow models backed by neural field representations. Each point on these planes maps to a flow vector, which shifts the ray intersection to correct for these other motion effects. Taking a closer look at these neural spline fields, we see that each is a network H, which maps a two-dimensional image coordinate UV to a 2×n vector of points P, interpreting these points as the control points of a spline S. We can interpolate these points for a time t to get a smooth two-dimensional function of flow, delta u, delta v. Note that time is never input into the network, but rather only used to interpolate its output, meaning the temporal behavior of these neural spline fields is entirely dictated by the number of points p we choose as its output dimension, independent of the data, training procedure, and loss functions. With two neural field image models for the obstruction and transmission layers, the shifted intersection points now sample the correct corresponding locations in these images. Let's take a brief detour to see what a simplified version of this looks like for only one image layer. Fit to this video of a swinging tree branch, we see how during training, the neural spline field learns to undo the scene motion. Playing it forward, we see how it smoothly warps space to match the motion of the original video. With each image coordinate mapped to a set of spline control points P, representing its path over time. Returning to our two-layer model, we multiply the obstruction layer by a learned alpha mat, multiply the transmission by its inverse, and then composite the two together to produce the output image. Our only regularization penalty being an optional weight on the alpha mat to control how much of the scene is modeled by the obstruction layer. Sampling the corresponding point in the predicted image and comparing to our original point from the burst frame, we calculate relative photometric error between these points and train all of the components of this model end-to-end via stochastic gradient descent. With only a couple minutes of training time, our model is able to completely remove the fence from in front of this tractor, and we can separate the reflection from this fox statue. Out-of-focus occluders pose no problem for our soft alpha-composited model. And for minuscule motion, we can even reconstruct objects hidden in the reflection behind the photographer. We can accurately recover content hidden behind large occluders, unseen in any individual frame, and remove photographer cast shadows from museum exhibits. Separating shadows that move with the phone from the static shadows on the statue's surface. Beyond natural hand tremor, we can use scene motion to help separate content layers. And with a single layer model, compensate for the motion of buildings outside of this airplane window. to implicitly fuse a sequence of noisy frames into a cleaner, high-resolution reconstruction. Thank you for watching.